In today's video, let's learn to execute SQL queries. I'm Santanu Lakshmi from EasyLearnSpot Search Learn Group. Before executing queries, let's see what is SQL. SQL means Structured Query Language. It is used to communicate with a database. SQL lets you to access and manipulate databases using queries. It allows you to query and retrieve the data from database. Now, let's learn SQL statements in detail. First comes the DDL, which stands for Data Definition Language, which defines the database schema and its structure. Next comes DML, which stands for Data Manipulation Language, which lets you to access, modify, and retrieve data from database. Third one is DCL, which means Data Control Language, which deals with the rights, permissions, and other controls of the database. Finally comes the DQL, which means Data Query Language, which is used for performing queries on the data in the database. Let's see the queries one by one with an example. We are going to use MySQL command line client to execute our queries. MySQL command line client is a software for executing the SQL queries. We can open the MySQL command line client by typing MySQL in the search option, and you can select MySQL command line client to execute the queries. So, first, let's open MySQL command line client and enter password. Once we opened it, we are ready to write our first query. Now let's see how to create the queries in MySQL. Our first step is to create a database. Every project should have a unique database name. We can have as many tables under the database, but there should be only one database name. So first, let's create a database. For creating the database, we can use the query create database and your database name. Here I have given it as EasyLearnSpot. And now your database has been created. Next, to display the list of databases, we just give the query as show databases. And every query should end with a semicolon. And now the list of databases are shown below. So here we can see that EasyLearnSpot is listed in the database. If we try to give the same query, create database EasyLearnSpot again, it will generate the error as can't create database EasyLearnSpot, which means the database already exists. Once we are done with the creation of database, we need to enter the database to proceed with the further queries. For entering or opening the database, you'll be using the query use database name. Here we have given the query as use EasyLearnSpot, and it shows us database changed. Our next step is to create a table under this database. So let's create a table. For creating a table, we are going to use the query as create table, table name. Here I have given it as emp, and I am going to give the column names. My first column name is emp id, and it will hold the values, integer values of maximum 5 digits. And my next field is EMP name, and it should be a varchar data type with the limitation of 15 characters. And next field is salary. So again, I'm going to give it as decimal. Its limitation is 10 digits, comma 2, which represents the round off value, and I'm going to end it with a semicolon. So I have forgot to given the last bracket, so it shows error. I have corrected the query. Now it shows query OK. Now your table has been created. To view the physical structure of the table, we can give the query as describe your table name. So it shows the physical structure, that is the name of the fields in the table and its data type. To list out the tables inside the database, we can use the query show tables. So it just lists out the name of the tables which resides under the Easy Learn Spot database. Next comes the insertion of the table data. So to insert the values inside the table, you can use the query insert into table name, that is EMP. We are going to give values, and I have three column names, so I am going to specify three values. So my first value is EMP ID. It is in integer, so I have given 100. I can give some name, and always varchar data type text should be enclosed within the double quotes. And finally salary, just close the bracket, end with the semicolon. So now the query shows OK and your value has been inserted. To view the table data inside the table, just give the query select star from table name, that is EMP. It shows the data inside the table. Now I want to add a row where I want to keep the salary as null. To leave some field as null, we are going to use the insert query, but we are going to specify the column names. That is, I want only the EMP ID and EMP name, and I am going to leave this field. So now if I give again select star from EMP, your salary value will be null. So you can also generate multiple values by just putting a comma and adding the values. Again, we can give select star from EMP to see the list of values in the table. So this is the way we insert the values inside the table. If I want to update the salary with some value, I can use the query call update query. So update your table name set. I'm going to give the salary as 20,000. But if I just end this query, it will update all the salary values with 20,000. So I don't want that to happen. So I'm just going to use the keyword where. I'm going to specify EMP ID equal to 101. So now it updates only the salary for the EMP ID 101. So it is updated. To check it again, select star from EMP. So now our table is complete with all the values filled out. Now let's see about select queries. The star in the select query represents, it displays all the columns in the table. If I want to display only a particular column inside the table, I can specify the name, EMP ID and EMP name. It displays only the column names, the particular columns inside the table. If I want to remove the duplicate values or hide the duplicate values from this table, that is, we have two values as 100 Shivi. So to hide the duplicate values, we can give the keyword distinct star from EMP. So it shows only one value, so 100 GB. It will not remove the values from your original table. It is just hiding the values for the visibility purpose. Next, let's see some information about the where queries. We are going to use where queries for operators. So first, let's see about arithmetic operators. We already know that we have many arithmetic operators like equal to, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to. In this, for equal to symbol and not equal to symbol can be used for all data types like integer, varchar, decimal, float, double. I have given the examples below. So it could be used for the name or it could be used with the salary. All the other operators, it can be used only for the numbers, that is for integer, decimal, float, and double. So let's see some of the queries. So here I am giving the equal to operator where name equal to, sorry, I have given as name, it is emp name. So it displays the particular column. If I use the same with not equal to symbol, except san, it displays all the other rows. And I can use the equal to symbol also for the salary operator. It displays the particular row. If I want to use greater than symbol, there is no value available in the row. So it shows empty set. For greater than equal to also, it will display the same result. But for greater than equal to, it displays 30,000 because I have given greater than equal to, so it will display the 30,000 value row. Now let's give the salary value as less than 30,000. Your output will be displayed which is below 30,000. If I give salary value as less than equal to 30,000, the lesser than value as well as the 30,000 will also be displayed. Next, let's see the not equal to symbol. So if I give salary with not equal to 30,000, other than 30,000, the remaining employee's salary will be displayed. Next, let's see logical operators. We have two logical operators, AND OR. AND means if it satisfies both the condition, we use the AND operator. If we want any one condition to be satisfied, we can use the OR operator. Let's see an example using AND and OR operator. Here in this, I have given the salary as equal to 30,000 and employee ID as 102. If both the condition is correct, the output will display. If any one of the condition is incorrect, for example, here salary is equal to 30,000 and employee ID is equal to 103, which doesn't match, so it displays the result as empty set. There is no such row available in our table. If I use OR operator with salary as 30,000 and employee ID as 101, both the results will be displayed. The salary 30,000 row will be displayed as well as the employee ID 101 row will also display. Next operator is like operator. So the like operator is to sort out the particular rows from the table. Here I am going to use the operator name as like, and I'm going to enclose the like operator text in between the double quotes, and we have another one symbol percentage. In the first example here, I have mentioned as percentage u. It will display the names which ends with the last character as u. It can have as many characters before u, but the last character should be u. And in the second example, I have given name like s percentage. It means that It displays all the names which starts with the S character, and it can have as many characters after S. And in the third example, percentage A percentage means A should be displayed anywhere in the middle of the word. We can have as many before characters, as many after characters too. So this is called the like operator. Here I have used the same symbol with the S operator, percentage symbol. It displays the result salary. It displays the table with an employee name which starts from S, as well as for percentage U, it displays the employee name which ends with U. And the next one is percentage I percentage. Here it displays the names which I in the middle of the words, or maybe it can be in the end, or it may be in the beginning of the word. So next let's see wildcard. Wildcard means if I want to search some specific name, I can use this format. It looks like missing letters. I can use hyphen to display the missing characters, but it should include the exact number of characters in that particular column. So here I have given var name like yes underscore I underscore I. It displays the employee name Shivi with along with the its row details. So you can just specify underscore, or you can specify some characters along with the underscore, but it should have the exact number of characters in that particular word. All these changes are done just for visibility purpose. It is not going to make changes in the original employee table. Next, let's see how to delete a particular row from the table. To delete a particular row, we can use the keyword delete from your table name, that is EMP, where EMP ID is equal to 101. So the particular row will get deleted. You can see from the output, that is the particular employee ID 101 row has been removed from the table. So delete keyword is used to remove a particular row from the table. Or we can delete a number of rows from the table. It is to delete the data from the table. If I want to clear all the data inside the table, I can use the keyword truncate table name. Here our table name is EMP, so truncate EMP. So it clears all the rows from the table. If I give select star from EMP query, it shows us empty set. However, the table is still existing. We have the physical structure of the table available, but only the data has been removed from the table. To remove the physical structure of the table also, we can use drop table table name. So here drop table EMP. Now our table is completely deleted from the database. So if I give the query show tables, it shows us empty set. It is not available in the database. To drop the database, I can use the query drop database, database name. My database name is EasyLearnSpot. It removes the database from the server. Now we have deleted our database also. If I try to show the show databases query, my database EasyLearnSpot is removed from the list. So drop query is used to remove the table as well as the database from the server. Let's learn about constraints. Constraints are the rules set for the data columns in the table. We have multiple constraints. We will see the constraints one by one by creating a table. Now let's create a table with create table query. Users, and we are going to have the columns as user ID, which is an integer, and next column name is username with varchar, and the third field is place, which is also varchar of 15. We are going to close the table. So this is your normal table. But if I want to add the constraints, I am going to add it beside my data type. So I am going to set the user ID with the primary key. So primary key is the one which needs to be set for the unique keyword. So there should be at least one primary key for every table. And my username column is, I am going to set it as not null keyword as well as unique keyword, which should be unique. And my place, I am not going to include any constraints. So just press enter. So we have created the table with constraints. Now to view the table, you can give describe users. So now we have created three columns and with the data types, and here we have set it as primary key for user ID. So primary key obviously means that it should not be left null. And username field, I have given it as unique. And place, I haven't set any constraints. Next, let's insert some values for the users table. Now we have inserted multiple values. When we try to enter the same values, insert the same values once again, see, it will show the error because we have set the user ID field as primary key. Primary key will not accept duplicate values. If I try to set the user ID and place, and I am going to leave the username column as blank, but it will not allow you because we have set not null constraint. So it will not allow you to leave that column as null. So I need to give the three values for it to enter. But if I try to enter only user ID and username, and if I try to enter, it also shows as duplicate entry fifth for key 2 because I have set that second field, that is username field, as unique. So it will also accept only unique values. Now we have inserted the values. Let's check the values of the table. Let's create another one table called orders, and I am going to have order ID as my first field with int data type, and I am going to set it as primary key. And the next column name is customer name, and that is varchar with 15 characters. And I am going to set it with not null constraint. My third column is user ID, which is the same user ID which I am going to compare it from users table. So I am going to differentiate it using the underscore. So this will be again integer, and here I am going to use the constraint foreign key. Foreign key keyword is references, so I am just give references, and I am going to refer the users table of user ID, and I am going to give the final column name as amount, which is the amount purchased by the users. Let's give integer of
10 and I'm going to give default. So default means that if you are not entering any values for that column, it will automatically take the default value as 1000. So I'm just closing the brackets and now your second table is created. Again, we will insert some values inside the table. Now let's view the table using select queries. So we have inserted the data inside the orders table. So now let's have a look at both the tables. This is our users table and this is our orders table. Now we are going to use these two tables to learn join. Joins are nothing but merging two tables and displaying the output as a single table. We have multiple joins, in that we are going to learn self join first. For self join, just use select star from orders comma users. Displays all the values and based on the table names order, it displays the values. Next comes the inner join. Inner join will compare the two tables, that is the foreign key of the second table will compare with the primary key of the first table, and if there is a match, it will display the result based on the match. Here we are using the keyword inner join. We are going to select star from orders inner join users, where orders of customer ID, that is user ID, orders dot user underscore ID is equal to users dot user ID. So it compares and displays the result based on the match. So when we compare the two tables, only the match 100 is there, so it displays the result. 101 is not there, so your result will not consist of 101. So only the matched result will be displayed in your output. Next query, we are just going to change the keyword, that is left join, and we are going to use the keyword on. So left join, it will produce the same result like inner join, but the remaining data in the left table, which is given here, this is called the left table and this is the right table, and the remaining results in the left table will also be displayed. So for right join, we are going to make a small change. Instead of left, we are going to use right join. So it displays all the values like inner join as well as the remaining values which is not in the right side table. When we compare, the remaining values extra, that is there in the right side table, will also be displayed. This is called right join. So with this, we are done with the basic SQL queries. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get further videos notifications. Thanks for watching.